Hi there, and welcome to another video of Made with Cables. My name is Mark, my handle on the forums is Andro, and today I'll be giving you a basic introduction to audio analysis techniques inside of Cables GL. So what does this mean? It means that we're going to be loading up an audio setup loader so we can grab an audio file, play it off, analyze it, and do something with the data that we get out of that. So today we're just going to focus on the average volume coming out of an audio file, how we can get it, visualize it, and do something meaningful with it. And we're going to keep it really nice and simple. In the upcoming tutorials, we'll ramp up the difficulty and complexity and show more advanced techniques. So I'd like you to pause the video and just make what you see here on the screen. Great, let's get started. So first of all, I'm gonna zoom out a little touch, move over here, I'm gonna press escape, and I'm gonna type in audio buffer. This holds an audio file or a sample. I'm gonna click add and move that over here. So right now, as you can see, I don't have a file loaded, so I'm gonna click this file browser. Here we have the new file manager inside of Cables. You need to be at library files. I'm gonna scroll all the way down to near the bottom, and here we have music. I'm going to load this one, Anthony Naples. And press escape. And as you can see, the file is loaded here. And we get the statistics about the audio file is finished loading, the sample rate, the length, the duration in seconds, number of channels. So it's stereo. So first of all, we need to play back basic audio. So I'm going to pull this out. And now I'm going to grab this next up underneath it, audio buffer player. Play back audio data stored in an audio buffer. I'm going to click add. Okay, so it's got a start stop button. So I'm going to press escape and I'm going to type in play button. Shows a playback button for forcing a simple user interaction. So basically, if you make an audio reactive patch and later on you're going to export it or have it somewhere in a web page, browser protocol expects the user to have to press this play button for the audio to start. So it's just a good idea to get used to using this now. So I'm going to drag this one out, click to false. I'm going to put it into start stop. And the last thing we need to do is hear the audio. So I'm going to drag this and pull it out. I'm going to type in output. Sends an audio signal to your speakers. I'm going to click add. Now, this is the total volume between 0 and 1. I'm going to put it in 0.25 because I'm giving the tutorial today. So if I press play now, I should just hear some music. Great. If I want it to stop, I click play button and I click reset. Okay, so this is our basic audio context, nice and quick and easy to set up. So now we need to analyze the audio. So I'm gonna pull this out and I'm gonna create the audio analyzer op. Extracts FFT or waveform data from an incoming audio signal. I'm gonna click add. Now, this guy needs a trigger. So I'm gonna pull this out over here. And now I'm going to press play, and I want you to pay attention to this part, average volume. So this is showing me the average volume of the audio file right now. There's a lot of settings here, FFT size and frequency, but we're just going to leave all that on default and just keep it nice and simple for today. So I'm going to click play button, and I'm going to click reset to stop. So I have this value coming out here. So I want to visualize that data. So first of all, let's go over here. And let's move this rectangle to the side, 0.75. And I'm gonna make it bigger, 1.5 by 1.5. And now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna pull this out and I'm gonna, actually, let's just copy paste this section. Control C, click here, Control V. Let's click and move this down. And now let's move this over there, say 0.75. So I want to visualize this data and the changing data over time. We've got a really good op for that. So I'm going to click escape, press escape. I'm going to type in graph. Draw a graph of a value into a texture. So I'm going to click add. Now, so this op produces a texture. So first of all, it needs a trigger. I'm going to grab the texture output. And I'm going to plug it into this basic material. And now here, we just need to plug in a value. So I'm going to get this value and I'm going to plug it into here. I'm going to press play and watch what happens. So So now we're getting the audio average volume visualized here. Now we can see the changes in the values over time, which makes things a lot easier. If I click on the graph up, I can also click this option, show min max. And this is a really handy way just to like tweak and analyze things and look at data that you're working with, not only with audio. So I'm going to click reset and stop it. Okay. So now I want to change the scale and say the rotation of this rectangle on the left-hand side based upon this information here. So first of all, let's just take a look at it. If I click it and drag and plug it into scale, how is it if it's just like raw data and we're doing nothing with it? It's going to be very noisy and jittery. So that's okay, but it's not exactly what we want. We want to have more ways to kind of like shape this data. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to look at the min and maximum that I'm getting here. You've got to sometimes let it run for a good 20, 30 seconds or jump to your loudest part of a track to get accurate data. So it's saying minimum 0, max 0.61. So I'm just going to press stop. So I'm going to get this output and I'm going to grab a map range up. It allows me to map a value from one range to another. So I know it was 0 and 0.61. And now I want to map it to 0 and 1. This is just easier to work with later on. Numbers that are just going between 0 and 1 are just easier to work with. So I'm going to grab this now. And I'm going to disconnect this one. And I'm going to get the output of map range. And I'm now going to plug this into graph. And I'm now going to plug it into scale. Press play. As you can see, the rectangle is now bigger. It's pretty much almost getting close to 1. And it's pretty impossible to get this stuff exact with audio. It's like audio analysis, so it's never going to be an exact science, but now it's like closer to what we want. So that's good, but it's still really jittery and noisy. So we need to smooth out the data. So we've got a really good app for that. And you might have guessed it's called Smooth. It smooths out jumps in values. So I'm going to add this app. This op needs a trigger, so I'm going to pull this down here. And I'm actually just going to reconnect this so it's just a little bit tidier with the patching. So now I'm just going to disconnect everything again because I want you guys to just see what's happening here. So I'm getting this map range, which is going from 0 to 0.61. It's being remapped to 0 to 1. I'm going to grab that value and I'm going to plug it into the value smooth. I'm now going to get the smoothed output and I'm going to plug it into graphs. And now I'm going to plug it into scale. Now watch what happens. It's already looking a bit better. So if I put this on 1, it's very fast and it's very jittery. If I put it on, say, 8, as you can see, it's starting to smooth out. If I'm going to put it on 16, it smooths out even more. And the best part is now that we're using the graph up here on the right side, we can see kind of what's happening. But as you can see, we've lost what we call the transient information. This is when, it's like when you hit a drum. There's a very loud peak of the sound at the beginning and it tails off at the end. So we kind of lost that information right now. It's kind of like here in this middle. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go here and I'm gonna click separate the increment and decrement factor. I'll explain what this means. So the increment factor is when a number is increasing, this is how much smoothing is applied. And with the decrement factor, when a number is decreasing, how much smoothing is applied. So right now, I'm just going to put them both on 1 and I'm going to press play. And as you can see, we've got all this transient information here now. So what happens if I put this on 8? So as you can see, it's popping up, but it's going back in a very smooth fashion. If I put this now on 32, you can see that we're keeping the transient information there, but we've still got this kind of thing going down. So I'm gonna now put this on 16. Put this now on 4, and I'm using this smooth op and these two values now to smooth out the response to these jumps in data. Right, so I'm gonna put it on 32 and 1. It's a little bit too slow, maybe 8. A little bit jittery still. 16, that's kind of feeling a little bit better now. So I'm like, okay, this is great. So basically, to recap, we check with the graph up what's the minimum maximum coming out of average volume, because that can change from track to track. We remap the range from the old minimum max to 0 and 1, that's a new value, and then we smooth it. Okay, so let's go one step further now. Let's grab these, do Control C, Control V, and copy it over here. I'm just going to grab the same value. I'm going to grab it there. I'm going to chain the trigger from smooth. And this I'm now going to plug into rotate Z. Okay, so we're not going to see much because we're only rotating it 1 degree. So I'm going to put the new min on minus 45 and the new max on 45. And the best part is now I can tweak this smooth here to have separate control. So it's not a very flashy example. It's not very visually impressive to look at, but this is the basics of how we can get the average volume coming out of the audio analyzer and how we can remap it to do meaningful things. So you've got to play around with these settings. You've kind of got to see what works for you, basically. And tweaking things to reactive audio is always a tricky thing, and that's kind of normal, but like, don't worry about it. It's not an exact science. It's just something you got to tweak for a long time to normally get it to be the way that you want. So in the next tutorial video, I'm going to show you how to split this audio up into 3 separate bands, which is bass, mid, high, and then how we can apply similar techniques and we can get much more accurate data out of the ops that we're going to use. Thanks for watching. I hope this video has been educational and informative. If you've got any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them under the video below or to post them on the forums. Thanks for watching and have a good one. Bye.